Hello everyone, my name is Aisha Meena. I will be giving a brief overview of our project Deep Image Prayer, done under the supervision of Professor Amit Sethi. The main aim of our project is to restore the original image from a noisy degraded image. Our project is mainly based on a pre-existing paper, Deep Image Prayer. Our project can be of great help in the field of image processing. Let's quickly go through the major steps involved in the process. So the first step is to initialize the input z and the weights theta randomly. Then we need to optimize the function e and the weights theta using gradient descent method. Finally, we can now obtain the final clear image using optimal value of theta. The detailed explanation of these steps are given in the report. Deep Image Prayer mainly revolves around three major tasks: denoising, super resolution, and in painting. But in our project, we have mainly focused on the first two tasks. Denoising, as the name suggests, is the obtaining a clean image from a noisy image. Let's consider a simple model, x0 equals to x plus epsilon, where x0 is the degraded image and x is the clear image. So here we have considered the noise to be additive. So here we can optimize the theta and obtain the clear image. So the next task is super resolution. Super resolution is the mapping of a low resolution image to a high resolution image. The image is first upscaled using interpolation method such as bilinear or bicubic interpolation, and then we use neural networks to obtain a high resolution image.
Hello everyone, this is Divyansh. I will try to explain the working of this denoising notebook in this project. Usually what we do for denoising is we train our model on different data sets on different images, and then we apply our trained model on some unseen data to get the denoised image of that noise image. But in this project, in the deep image prior, what we do is we train our model on a single image. So like this is the image, the ground truth of the image, and this is the noisy image. So what we do is we train our model on this particular image. We have some untrained model and we train that model on this particular image, only this image. And we sort of try to generate this image from some random noise. Like we input some random noise to the model and we try to generate this image from that that random noise. And what we do is we try to manipulate the weights of that model, generate this image from the model. But in the process of generating this image, so I will show the development of the image here. Let me go to the top. So this is the random noise that we gave as an input to the network, and so it is just at zero iterations, this is just the output of the model. It is a complete random noise. But at 100 iterations, we can see some sort of a structure to this. Like the output is some sort of structured image. I don't know if this image is resembling the previous image or not, the actual ground truth or not, but this is some type of a structured data. And as we go on, as we increase the number of iterations, when we go to the 600 iterations, it some sort of looks similar to the initial ground truth of the image. It is not very similar, but it sort of resembles that. And when we go to somewhere around 1500 iterations, and this is less 2400 iterations. So when we are at 2400 iterations, the image is exactly looking like that of like that ground truth. Okay, so this image like slightly deviates. The contrast is high in this image, but it sort of resembles more closely the ground truth of the image. So it has some well-defined boundaries. It has good colors, but the contrast on the face is high, as you can see. But the two images are, this is the output image for 2300 iterations. This is the output, and this is the average output. Like this is the average of all the outputs that the network have till 2300 iterations. Okay, so what we do here is we take some image and add noise to it. So it is ground truth, it is a noisy image, and we sort of give some parameters, like the input is noise, and these are some parameters that are required by the network to build up. And here we create the network. This is the escape net which we create. With the escape net is some sort of neural network, the sequential neural network that we are building with escape layers in that. So what escape layers do is they sort of add some randomness to the model, so that the model does not overfit, because if the model overfits, yes, then it will just output the noise image as it is. Okay, so this is the number of parameters that we have in the model, and this optimization function, it is the optimization functions that we are running. So what the optimization function is doing, it is calculating some output average. This is the output average that we are this is the output average that we are generating, and this is the output. This is just the output for some particular iteration. Okay, and we are calculating the MSE loss for this, the MSE loss between the output of the network and the original and the image, the noisy image that we have. And this is the PSNR. So what PSNR does is, PSNR is sort of some matrix that gives us a that evaluates how much signal is there in comparison to the noise in that signal. Okay, so this is the peak signal to noise ratio. and we are just comparing the image that put our output image with our ground truth and actual noise image. So this is the optimization function, and this is the building up of the image. As I'm going to build up the image, this is the sort of building up process, and here we plot the MSE loss that we have and the PSNR that we are having here. So PSNR is the output image PSNR. So you can see that MSE loss is a typical exponential function, so it sort of decreases with number of iterations. But here the PSNR is we stipulate time, and then we sort of attain a peak at around 2500 iterations, and that, then we go down. So what this resembles is when we are at this peak, then we have like minimum noise in the signal. So the noise ratio, the amount of noise compared to that of signal is very low here. So we have more signal than noise at this peak. So what we can do is we can terminate our iterations at 2500 iterations, and then we will get an image that more closely resembles to the ground truth. Okay, so yeah, so this is just the output. This is the output image from the network. This is the output, and this is the noise image that we provided to the network, and this is the ground truth. So we do not use ground truth in our network anywhere. We use the ground truth just to see how much the output resembles the ground truth. So we can see that there is a good resemblance.
Hello everyone, I am Piyush. I'll talk about super resolution as implemented by DeepImageProyer. As you all know, what super resolution is, you take a low resolution image and basically give a high resolution image as output, considering a factor which is given t, suppose. Divyansh has already shown you a demo, so I'll just quickly pass through the demo of super resolution and then talk about the network architecture which both the tasks, super resolution and denoising, use. So as far as demo for this picture is concerned, we take the input same as denoising one, and this is how it carries on its journey. So at zero iteration it looks like this. 200 iterations it forms, it starts forming. 400 iterations, 600 iterations, 800, 1000, 1200 iterations, and the picture is forming. 1600 iterations, 1800 iterations, 2000, and now changes are almost negligible. 2400, 2600, 2800, 3000, 3200. I'll just sum this part as well, like for comparison. So this was the final image that we had as our output, and this is the original image that was there. As the PSNR value for the high resolution image is the orange curve, and I suppose that it will go down. It is not visible, but it will go down as in the case of denoising curve after a few more, like after 10,000 maybe to 5,000 more iterations. That was not actually computable. Show you one more example of zebras. So for zebras, this was the input that was taken. This is a bicubic interpolation, and this was the interpolation that was given by the model implemented by DeepImageProyer. This case as well, the PSNR value forms an orange curve, forms a plateau, and these are some comparative images. The leftmost one is the true image, is the ground truth, and the right image is the how the image is slowly forming. Let me talk about the network architecture, which is quite important. So the network architecture is basically a hourglass type of architecture, and you'll see how the output shape is constantly reducing from 384,576 to 192,288, 96,144, 48,72, 24,36, and after, like, it has decreased a lot, it will now start increasing. 12,18, it will start increasing now. 24,36, 48,72, 96,144, 192,288, 384,576. This is like the size that we ended with, and this is the size that we have started with. And there are a number of convolutional neural layers, leaky batch normalization layers that are acting in here. They are upsampling layers, downsampling layers, and as well as there are certain skip connection layers, which are these. Four channels are being outputted. There are certain skip connection layers as well. So basically, what the idea is that these skip connection layers aid in the formation of the image. Yeah. So that's it. Thank you very much.